Good morning and welcome back to the channel. You're joining me in Germany, where I'm making my way through the Black Forest towards a train. Now, I know what you're thinking, is this going to be another episode where I'm chasing a train across level crossings? And don't worry, it's a diesel engine, so I'm not going to be doing that. But there's a little museum and stuff that I want to check out. But on the way, we're going to have a fun drive through the Black Forest, or the SchwarzenWald, which is a beautiful place in Germany. We're going to see a lot of nice things along the way. This morning I parted ways with Naeem as he's on his way up to Denmark, through Germany as well, but you know, it just became a case of one of us is going north, one of us is going south.
Hey, oh, goodbye.
You need to get going. Yeah, it was great to have him along, but for now we're back to solo. Me, you, and Daisy Bell makes three. Let's get into it. Talk about industry. Back into France again. Strange, right? Oh, beautiful color. We can go above 30 on this road. The last, I'd say, 15 kilometers have just been 30 with tiny stretches. Oh, look, 80. 30 with tiny stretches of 50 and even smaller stretches of 70. And then you're back into 50 and 30 again. But hopefully now we can start picking up some nice speed. J'ai oublié de dire merci à Alan pour la information regarding les vitesses en Allemagne. I forgot to say thank you to Alan for this information on the speed limits in Germany. Apparently there's some kind of war going on between motorcyclists and the government. That they want, there's like two speed limits, one for cars and then one for motorbikes. That's a different one, about half the speed. So it might be a 100 kilometer road, but you're only supposed to go 50 or something like that. I think this was 2 years ago, and it'd probably be, I hope I'll be okay, but we'll see if I get stopped. Well, that would be a problem, but we're just gonna go on and chance it. Should be fine, right? I mean, we're not very loud. We're nice and low rumble, but not low pop. Now this is more like it. Woo! Nice and chilly here as well. Not a bother to you, cool as a breeze. Heard of fucking Austria, but bitch France is a new one. Now that's not bad language, that's the names of the towns. But I think the former, they changed the name because the sign kept getting stolen. I stopped for a quick check to see if there was any supermarkets or anything open that I could just get a quick sandwich in or something, but it is Sunday, so No luck there. We press on. But I did find this kind of cool place. It's sort of an old abandoned rail yard, I think. Had a little wander through. There was a big old, what would you call it? Like a steam piston, giant engine generator. Had a little poke around, being cheeky like that, you know. But, and then I had a look in this cottage, and I started to get, I might get stabbed vibes, so I thought I'd quit while I was unstabbed and hit the road again. There was like a chair in the middle of the floor and nothing else around it. Just, ooh, it's a bit spooky vibes. I've seen this movie before, you know. But yeah, let's press on. Yeah. Willkommen aus Deutschland. Welcome back to Germany. We are 2.5 hours from our destination, or 135 kilometers. Damn. I think that sort of black forest up there is the Black Forest, so... Followed by the mountain. Sommerberg Tunnel. Very spooky. Whew! Back in the clean air. What views though. Really is motorcycle country. I don't think we're even at the best bits yet, to be honest. Mint condition. Ooh. Don't know what that is, but it's gorgeous. It's a brother. What are the chances? First Royal Enfield I've seen in Germany, I think. We're gonna have some fun on this road, aren't we? Come to a bit of an impasse here. Here, Vending. I'm not sure what that means, but we'll try to go around the other way. We'll have to go around if we can. Bit of a shame backtreading a little, but that's okay. I can think of worse places to be for this. I accidentally took this right turn rather than the way that I went and turned around because I thought it was the wrong way, but this might be the only way we can get there. I'll be honest with you, I'm not sure what forest is in German, but I know blackish forts, so I think we're here. Fallenbühlstraße is what we're on now, so maybe it's Foren, so Schwarzenforen. Either way, I think welcome to the Black Forest. Yeah. That's forest in German. SchwarzenWald. Black forest. Anyways, we're just about here, I believe. I thought it was going to be in the heart of the Black Forest, but I guess this is sort of that, isn't it? A big clearing in the heart of the Black Forest? I'm not sure. That looks like Die Bahnhof, the train station. I think there's a museum and stuff. I just like to have a little look-see, you know? Yeah, big Deutschen engines. Willkommen aus dem Bahnhof Solhaus Blumberg. If that's the correct language. Yes, we might even get something to eat. It's been, well, all day. Woof! Little piece of a train. Okay. I think they have diesels running today, but there is like two steam engines, which are, that's the thing that I'm interested in, you know? Let's go in. Fascinating stuff, if you're into trains, that is. Otherwise it's probably not been that fascinating for you. Oh look, normal trains go there too. Yeah, it looked like I got there at just the right time because the big train was arriving. Just have a little look at it, you know. Go on, you cheeky bullet. Yeah, the museum, it seemed to be free. I hope it was, and I didn't just rob them by looking at the stuff for free, but nice little place. They do run steam engines as well, but I think at the moment they have like a diesel engine month going on. If it was steam engines, maybe we'd go chase it again like we did in France, but I think for now I'm happy to head off and hit the road. It was cool to see at least one of those big black and red engines. I think they have a very unique look to them compared to like American or British steam engines. British steam engines are kind of a smaller scale than these. That black and red one was, let's talk and drive. The black and red one there was actually a small enough one as German trains engines go, from what I know. And those had been around since, well, at least that style of engine, I think, with the black and red, was around since the Prussian times in Germany. So all the way from Imperial Germany to the Reichsbahn and through onto the Bundesbahn, which is what I think it is now, or Deutschbahn, German railways. The little tiny green engine was cute, I think you'd agree. That probably would have been used for yard work, you know, pulling coaches to and fro and attaching them to trains and whatnot, rather than actual long distance work, because it doesn't really have a coal bunker, so it would fill up as it needed to in a rail yard. At least I think so. I'm not as into trains as I used to be when I was younger, but from what I can remember, it's something like that. If you're in the area, I think it'd be worth giving a go if you have small kids. They'd love it, the novelty of it, you know? For now, we're on to Pfulling. Pfullendorf? I can't remember where it's called, but it's about an hour and 6 minutes from here, according to specifically that. Oh, what have we done? Yeah, all in all, not a bad day. I enjoy kind of mid to long distance and a little visit in between sort of drives. Oh look, we have the boys behind us. There's one. There's two. And there's three. Have a good time. I could do the 100, but I prefer to sit at 80. Just, you know, easier on El Daisy. You don't need to give it socks, okay? Yeah, it was cool to see inside the signal building at the top. Very old-fashioned. I can picture it in old films and things, like Von Ryan's Express, that sort of look with the all the telephones and the levers and stuff everywhere. Yeah, it's great. I'm driving on to Pfullendorf. You gotta be pulling my leg, I don't remember what it's called. But luckily Zoom will remember. Thank you for watching this video, I hope you enjoyed it. For me, I'm gonna go watch the Sound of Music tonight in preparation for where I'll be heading tomorrow, if that's any clue. I think we should have a beautiful ride tomorrow. But for now, you have a lovely day yourself, and I'll talk to you after. Bye!